Oh my god, people. Big news just happened right now in Destiny 2. We got some new weapon types. We have rework of vendors, usefulness for legendary shards, new mechanics to get different kind of mods for your weapons, new vendor rework, a whole lot of stuff coming here in Destiny 2. So if you want to check out what all the updates are, stay tuned to the channel here. We'll get you more updated on this. If you'd like to see more news update videos like this, please make sure to tap that like button. Let me know you want to see more content like this. Tap subscribe for to stay up to date for more news and awesomeness as well. So let's get right into the video here. So as we all know, the main complaint right now in Destiny 2 is endgame. The endgame sucks. Oh my god, Bungie, can you even make a game? Well, they can. And I know that for a fact, from what my experience was in Destiny 1, that Bungie genuinely cares about making a good game, and they're gonna listen to your feedback and turn around and give you something awesome and more, and then some more. And people have been complaining a lot, but man, endgame is terrible right now. Bungie, your silence is deafening. Like, they're just working on stuff right now. They're not gonna come out and tell you things. But anyways, so we got a new update here in Destiny 2 coming for you guys. I'm gonna go over it with you guys right here. So if you wanna check it out, here we go. So the state of the game here, and basically it just kind of talks about what the recent release, we've listened to your feedback, all that good stuff from Luke Smith and Chris Barrett, the two big guys over at Bungie. And so they've been right here, they kind of give you short sweet about what's coming for Destiny 2, like ranked matches for Crucible are coming. It says private matches for Crucible still targeted for early 2018, so I'm assuming sometime before August, or sometime before April, sorry. Usually we get a nice April update. Better rewards for Strike, Adventures, and Lost Sectors. Yes, please. Strikes are awesome, Adventures are awesome, and Lost Sectors are great as well, but just the rewards suck. There's no point to doing them after you beat like the campaign. That's all, after that, that's kind of useless. Some tuning for comes to supremacy and a whole bunch of other stuff. So, but the big stuff here is boom, new weapon type called Masterworks. These Masterwork weapons take your legendaries and make them even better. And so something like doing like the raid or doing Trials of the Nine will give you a better odds of having a Masterwork weapon drop, but there is also a chance you can kind of grind your way up to it. Now the great thing about this too is that the Masterwork mod, as you can see, like right down here, I'll actually point like right that way, yes, somewhere around there. it's like a mod kind of thing that you get, and you can generate a small amount of different kind of perk rolls on that weapon to kind of customize it how you like, which I think would be a great thing to say if you get a Masterwork, you don't like the perk on it, kind of grind out whatever perks you want on it, and then you get to have your own personal weapon, which I think is a great way to do it. Add customization, randomization for your weapons. I think this is a great change, and I think a great combines both the random perk rolls that some people like and the stagnant rolls, which I like personally. And I think it combines the two really well together. So for example, on this one, for this Yuri's Gift, it says this weapon generates orbs on multi-kill and displays the number of enemies defeated by using it. And I think you can also do just Crucible as well, which actually is the one that really matters when it comes to that one. I think that would be fun to have as a actual perk. But you can see, adds a different kind of element to it, and it's really great. Let's say like the different ones are track and display number of kills with a weapon, with choice between total kill count or just Crucible only. Of course, you're gonna do Crucible only. Generate orbs for you and allies on multi kills. Add weapon stab bonuses that are selected randomly for a small pool and are re-rollable. That's great. And it's gonna be like stats as in like increase handling, increase impact, damage, reload. That's what it sounds like to me. So these Masterworks gonna be dropping for you if you're anywhere over any activity that's with a power level, over 250 as well. It says unwanted Masterworks can be dismantled into materials that can upgrade an existing legendary weapon into a Masterwork. Now I'm assuming it's probably gonna be assault rifles to assault rifles, you know, shotguns to shotguns. It can't be kind of like how it is now when it comes to dismantling. I'm sure it's going to be probably about that same kind of thing as well. Now we have armor ornaments coming as well, so you get the more visual customization for your character, new way to grind out your character to make him look exactly how you like. And so you can see right here in this little graph right here, you have some ornaments on the bottom of your vendor. And you see right here, matches 125. So you actually have to grind out, do something to earn these ornaments, which is awesome. It's so great to see that, you know, developers are still trying to do this, and you reward players for playing their game. And so these are kind of mechanics I think are really great. So you got all the armor sets are going to get different kinds of ornaments, like Vanguard, Crucible, Trials of the Nine, Iron Banner, Dead Orbit, Future War Cult. Say that five times fast. New Monarchy and the Eater of Worlds raid lair. Nothing insane about the actual Leviathan raid, but I think that's what Prestige mode is for. Is kind of you get your ornaments by playing that, which is great. And so now this also rework of different kind of vendors who have items. You get to have to grind out tokens. So tokens are still necessary, but you can see here, for example, you might see that might be kind of small on the screen. Let me kind of zoom in on this right here for you guys. That should be working. You're working just fine right there. So you can see, you can actually buy specific items that you want, which is gonna be so great, especially when it comes to doing things like Faction Rally or Iron Banner, where you want to get a full armor set instead of just grinding out random stuff that you don't want, just tossing out, dismantling. Oh, look, I finally got this thing I wanted after like 500 tokens. You don't have to really deal with that much more, because what you'll be able to do is that you'll have to earn a certain amount of tokens and then have a certain amount of shards to buy a specific item. Now, you can see over here on the far right underneath my head right here, let me kind of duck down a little bit for you. They have one item that will rotate every week, which would be great. And so you get different ornaments from him right here. And you also have a miscellaneous item down here, which I believe is actually what the gift item will be, which will be discussed later in this video as well. And also we have Zer. He's gaining a different kind of... You get some updates as well. As you can see right here, three of your coins are coming back. Now this is going to be a straight 4-hour... increase to you and your party for getting legendary. It's not going to be some weird mechanism of like do it right before a boss, or there's some weird stacking mechanic. It's just a flat boom, there you go. And then with Zer, they're also bringing in what are called Fated Engrams. And the point of these is that it'll give you an opportunity to unlock a exotic that you don't currently have right now. So to avoid duplicates, as you can see right here, it will contain a new exotic if any remain to be collected. Looks like the cost is going to be 97 legendary shards. So we're going to be spending a lot more legendary shards, which is going to be great, because I've just been stockpiling my legendary shards like crazy and I have nothing else to do with them. So it's going to be awesome. Now we also have Banshee 44, the gunsmith. He's getting some rework as well. You can see, and now what they're going to be doing is that with all those blue mods, those rare mods that you had, they're taking up all your inventory. And like, man, I wish I could just sell them all, but I need them, so whatever. Well, this time you actually get the chance to dismantle those mods, save your inventory space, and then which will give you right here mod components right there. You see, if I move my head a little bit actually this way, you'll be able to see it a little better. You'll need 5 mod components and 10 legendary shards to buy a legendary mod, which would be, it's just such a great life improvements right now for this game that is definitely needed for sure. We can see right here for players. So basically, just kind of saying everything I mentioned before. For players chasing a world. This is all, mostly changes are coming on December 12th. Some of these changes are coming December 5th with the Curse of Osiris DLC coming out, which I will be live streaming. You guys will be seeing me do some live streamings for that when it is released, so keep an eye out for that for sure. I'll definitely put up a notification on this channel when the stream will happen for sure. I will let you guys know for sure on that. So for players chasing a world legendary or looking for Masterworks, Master Rahul will sell some of his rumored hoard of legendary engrams for legendary shards as well. So you get to just buy legendary shards, have a random weapon drop, and see what happens, you know? So just giving some purpose to buy, use your legendary shards. I think they're doing it really, really well. So changes affecting reputation tokens. Daily challenges will have reputation tokens rewards increase across the board. Cage treasure chests will still offer viable rewards, but not guarantee, at minimum, a payout of destination-appropriate reputation tokens. Strikes will drop a larger number of Vanguard tokens. Common quality destination resource tokens will have their own drops increased to 100%, and values per token increase by 450% common and tokens. Da, 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 da. I can't read. There's just so much stuff. Oh my god, this is great. And they also kind of go into talking about the XP mechanic as well. This is a huge info dump right here. So if you guys want to really dig in deep, dig even more than I have for you guys right here in this video, highly suggest just kind of going in and checking out the post itself. Will be linked in the description down below. Now, what are my thoughts on this? Well, I am super psyched for this. This is going to be a great addition. Now, when it comes to the master, I'm mainly excited for the masterwork weapons. This is going to be a really great idea to help give you a reason to grind out things, to give yourself exactly what you want. Now, honestly, I really would like to see a real grind when it comes to wanting to change a perk on the weapon. I feel like you need to put a considerable amount of hours to grind out a specific kind of perk that you want. This reminds me very similar, say, like in Diablo 3, if you guys ever played that game, the transmog lady, I can't remember her name at the moment, but you can enchant items, which basically give you a chance to re-roll a single stat on an item. And that what that will do is, out of like a long list of different kind of perks and rolls and stat rolls, and each stat roll having variations from like 10 to like 8 to 15% like damage boost of a certain fire boost or something like that, that this will hopefully kind of bring that, a much more streamlined, minor, smaller version of that. But it's really great, so you can have a chance to kind of keep a weapon that you really like, or maybe a weapon that you're like, man, I really like this weapon, I just wish it had like this kind of little salt and a little pepper on that. Well, you get to put a little dash or a little seasoning on it, however you like, to kind of customize your weapon to make it your own, which I think is going to be great. I would just like to see a considerable grind if you want to change your perks, especially if just for these weapons just to drop in general, because I feel like a big thing with this with Destiny 2 is that the weapons dropped really easily and you got everything really quickly, and then it kind of left everyone going, I don't know what to do anymore because I have everything I want. And so it's always a hard thing to do with these kind of games, is that trickle down of all the things that you want. Like, is you definitely want to give players an item that's reasonable to grab within a certain amount of reasonable time, but not too easy to where it will just like what happened with Destiny 2, that we got everything we wanted and now we're just kind of bored. We're like, well, there's no incentives to play besides just play Crucible, and I don't really like Crucible that much. But anyways, so I'm really excited for this. This is just a step in the right direction, as I knew that, Bungie was going to take the time and effort to really give us something good. I know that people, I've seen a lot of videos on YouTube of people complaining, going like, oh my god, Bungie, your game is terrible, you don't even know what you're doing, and like, your silence is deafening, and kind of things like that. Well, like, Bungie, they hear us, the community, talking about their game, they pay attention, what they want to do is give us what we want, and then we should, in Bungie fashion, they can do that and some more. That's something better that you would just want, not just trying to bow down to Destiny community, but actually giving you something more than what you asked for. And I think Bungie is doing a great job taking the steps in the right direction for that. Still are things that need to be addressed for sure, but at the moment, I'm pleased to hear that. It's giving reason to use your legendary shards. It's giving you a chance to give you like a reroll customization for a new kind of weapon, which is going to be great. I'm a little afraid that with new players that the masterworks are going to be a little more confusing compared to seasoned players, but I think at this point now, whoever is going to play Destiny 2 is probably going to play it, besides for the Christmas noobs. So by the time, say, February rolls around, pretty much everyone who's going to be playing Destiny 2 is going to be playing Destiny 2. And so I'm excited for this. Leave a comment down below, guys, what you think about this update. I'm excited for it. Are you excited for it? Is it going to bring it back to Destiny 2 or make you even think about, like, hey, you know what? Destiny 2 sounds like a pretty fun game now. Maybe I should pick it up. Because I would say probably you should, because it's actually a really fun game. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. If you enjoyed this kind of video, please make sure to tap that like button. Let me know you want to see more content like this. If you want to see more content, well, you can always tap the subscribe button for more awesome Destiny 2 and Halo 5 content, or just Halo content in general, I should say, really. And anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Keep an eye out for that The Curse of Osiris live stream happening on the 5th. You'll definitely be seeing me online doing that. And anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Greatly appreciate it. I'll catch you all in the next video.